Canelo Triple G, Abel Sanchez says that Triple G will do to Canelo what Mayweather didn't do to Canelo and dominate him. I thought Mayweather dominated Canelo.
I think so. Yeah, definitely.
Ricky, yes. Abel Sanchez says, the conference call the other day, that Gennady Golovkin will do to Canelo what Mayweather didn't do and dominate him. Wasn't that a dominating performance?
What,
So, I mean, what does he mean? You mean that Triple G will knock him the fuck out, like just kill him? Or?
Probably.
Do you think so? Do you
I
think?
Believe there's going to be a knockout.
Who? By who?
Triple G.
He's going to knock out Canelo?
I think so. That's where I have my money right now. Got a lot of bets right now.
It's possible.
I'm going for Canelo.
I know you are. I like Canelo. Look, there's nothing wrong. Just that, you know, this is a good fight. This is a very good fight. I just feel because Triple G's a bigger guy. That's his natural weight. I believe he's far better opposition that he had.
So you got Triple G all the way?
Yeah, even though, look, Canelo has fought good opposition, but he didn't look good against Floyd at all.
But he was 22.
There you go with the age. Who gives a shit? Now they're talking about, he was too old, you know.
Who? Who's too old?
People always say that, he's too old. He beat him, was too old. Yeah, he beat him, he was too young. You should be in your fucking prime when you're that young, 21. When you're young, you gotta beat up.
Okay, if Canelo today fights Mayweather, same result exactly?
Right now, yeah, no. I think.
That's Canelo, my point, bro. Thank you. Yeah. But so still, I'm right.
Then why you put him in there at that age then? If you know he's gonna get his ass kicked.
Because you never know.
Oh, well, there you go. You know that he got his ass kicked.
What do they fought at 154, not 152?
Oh, stop. Doesn't matter.
What do you say? Why do you got Triple G? Are you one of those?
Would have, could have, should have, but didn't happen.
You're one of the Mexicans for Triple G, right?
Yeah.
Who you got, Canelo or Triple G?
Triple G.
Everybody in this gym, Triple G?
Well, I guess you can say his career from the beginning. I won't be able to name all the fighters that he's fought, but the fight that I have seen with known and unknown, because also that is the truth, they have been big fights in terms of the opponents that he's had have always been his size or much bigger, whoever it is, but they've always been his weight class. And for that?
Not 100%. Ricky.
Yeah.
Gabe Rosado was a 154 fighter that moved up to 60. So was Willie Monroe.
Yeah.
And when he fought, who's the kid from DC? Dominic Wade only had 16 fights when he fought Triple G and with like 6 knockouts.
Yeah. But I guess,
so you're smiling, but you know, like, yeah. Triple G's a beast, a monster. But his fights
Both of them are beasts. Canelo's a beast. I think he learned a lot from the Floyd fight. He learned a lot. You know, he came back and whooping everybody's ass.
Canelo.
And not only did he learn the boxing part of it, but from what I saw was how to handle himself as a boxer in the business perspective. He learned that from Floyd by, now look at the fights he took and everything.
Your prediction for the fight?
I say 8 rounds and Canelo gets dropped. Not a knockout, but he will get dropped.
Okay, Ricky?
I believe he's gonna stop him.
Canelo will stop
Triple G has to stop him or knock him out, because if it goes to the decision, Canelo's going to win.
I agree. I agree that Canelo's going to win. So
yeah,
thanks.
Canelo's
going
to win if it goes to the decision.
Canelo's going to win regardless.
It's not going to go to
the... Do you want to bet? We have a bet, don't we?
No. I don't bet anymore.
You said we have $500 to bet.
When?
Look, I have $4,000 right now on the table.
Well, share some of the money when you win it, Ricky.
How much you got to eat?
All right, we're in the new kosher restaurant on Fulton and Burbank. Shalom, shalom.
Oh, really?
You should go to Tel Aviv instead.
I don't like Tel Aviv.
Really?
For some reason, the portions are huge. Don't get me wrong. And they give you fries and stuff. But I just don't like their food. I'm not used to that one. But anyways, you're helping Ricky at his house again?
Yeah.
What are you guys building now? You build a living room, you build one bathroom?
One bathroom. Just you know, small items that are there to make it
Ricky,
more, livable.
Why do you renovate your house every 2 months? You want to feel like you moved or something? Like it's a new
home?
Yeah,
I want to go. I won't have to go buy another bigger place.
Can you build
I'm content with a small place that I have.
How about a panic room? Can you build it more like in the movies with the like metal? Like
Ellie, I would build a panic room, but I would be underground. If I had a lot of money, I'll build my nice, big-ass panic room.
But the problem is you're in Southern California because of earthquakes. We don't really have basements. But in the East Coast, you could do it.
You reinforce it. You put steel around it.
And food to last you 6 months if you have to disappear.
Well, yeah, in a year. If I have to go to my own prison.
But you'll be fully armed, locked and loaded, with Chico.
What's
Chico.
Up,
All right, so there you have it, Canelo Triple G. We're very excited. September 16th. Stay tuned. PeaceNewsReporting.com and Ballistic Mike reporting.
Reporting.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.